Hi, I'm Rong Ji with Keysight Technologies. SCPI Recorder is now available in XApp. It allows you to record every operation on the instrument keypad or touchscreen. In today's video, we'll talk about how to use SCPI Recorder to save your time for the automation test. We'll show you SCPI list and the script generation, find and show SCPI command, and the customized user menu. Let's start in SCPI list and the script generation. First, go to the System Settings window, press SCPI Recorder tab. You can turn on Continue SCPI Recording to start the SCPI recording, or you can right-click on any configuration parameter to open up the pop-up menu. If you are using touchscreen, just touch and hold for 1 second to open up this menu. After that, press button called Start SCPI Recorder. This will enable Continue SCPI Recording as well. After enabling Continue SCPI Recording, it goes into the automatic mode. In this mode, you can start the recording process in advance of a certain configuration sequence and stops it after finalization of all necessary configuration steps. Let's see how it works for 5GNR demodulation measurement. So, let's switch to Modulation Analysis Measurement, then go to Mass Standard tab. Select RB Allocate Preset to Downlink Test Model 3.1B. Press Apply Preset. After that, we can see the modulation is correct via the constellation diagram and EVM summary table. A further improvement I can do here is go to the Settings tab and press Optimize EVM button. After that, EVM has been improved. Now, let's go to the SCPI Recorder tab. The SCPI list for 5GNR demodulation have been created automatically, which records all manual operation we did before. This is what we want. You can toggle off the Continue SCPI Recording to stop automatic recording, or you can right-click on any configuration parameter to open up the pop-up menu. After that, press button called Stop SCPI Recorder. This will disable Continue SCPI Recording as well. After disabling the Continue SCPI Recording, it goes into the Menu SCPI List mode. Let's see how it works. Let's turn on Single Measurement and press Restart. Then go to the Advanced tab, press Advanced Mode Setup. In the General tab, let's turn on DC Punctured and right-click on this parameter to open up the SCPI Operation menu. Let's press Add to the SCPI Recording button, then do the same operation for the EVM in DB settings. Now, let's go back to the SCPI Recorder window. We can see that only operations which we press Add to the SCPI Recorder are listed here. The operations like Turn on Single Measurement and Restart are not recorded. This is what we want. There are multiple operations provided here to edit SCPI list. You can select the SCPI command to move up and move down, or you can delete the single command, or you can even delete all commands in the list. What's more, copy button makes any SCPI command available on the fly by a simple copy-paste operation, and you can play back all SCPI commands as well. The SCPI list you created here can be exported for further SCPI programming use. You can press Save button and select SCPI Recorder. Save all commands into a SCPI script file. Meanwhile, SCPI Recorder also provides record SCPI script file function to play back series of operation in the same or another instrument, which helps you set up complex measurement scenarios quickly and easily. Now, let's take a look at Find and Show SCPI command. You can right-click on any configuration parameter to display its SCPI command via pressing button Show SCPI command. After that, the corresponding SCPI command window will pop up. Copy-paste operation makes the SCPI command available on the fly. What's more, helps the setting, saves your time hunting through the programming guides. It gives you development information of the parameter, such as command example, dependencies, or value format. It reduces your SCPI programming efforts to the minimum. Next, let's see how to do customize the user menu for fast measurement. Right-click on any parameter you may frequently use. Then in the pop-up menu, press Add to the User menu. After that, go to the User menu. You can see the parameter has been added in the User menu now. If you want to delete the parameter in the User menu, just right-click on the parameter and select Remove from the User menu. It provides a fast operation for those parameters you may frequently use, or some parameters which are in the multiple subtabs. To learn more and to download a free trial, visit us at these websites. Thanks for watching.